Hi friends, today we will talk on the pipes and system. So what is the meaning of this? If you have a tank and here we have shown two pipes that will fill the tank and one pipe it will be empty the tank. So maybe there are more than one pipe or one pipe and there are also more than one pipe or one pipe. So how to solve such type of problem? You have to understand the first one. If a pipe can fill a tank in X hours, then the part filled in 1 hour, that will be 1 upon X. It means that it will fill 1 upon X part in 1 hour. Already we have discussed in work and wages. In work and time, you must go there. If a pipe can empty a tank in y hours, then the part of the full tank emptied in 1 hour, that is 1 upon y. If a pipe can fill a tank in x hours and another will empty the full tank in y hours, then you will subtract that this one is filling and this one is, it will empty the tank. So 1 upon x minus 1 upon y, part will be filled in 1 hour. If both pipe has been opened and it is taking x hours and it is taking y hours, so it will fill 1 upon x part and it will fill 1 upon y part. In this condition, the total part filled in 1 hour, that will be 1 upon x plus 1 upon y. Now at last, if two pipe it has opened and one pipe it is just like in this position, so it will empty the tank and it will fill the tank. So overall 1 upon x plus 1 upon y minus 1 upon z will be filled in 1 hour. So you have to understand the logic. By the help of this logic we will solve some questions. Now we will start. So your first question is, two pipes A and B can fill a tank in 36 hours and 45 hours. If both pipes are opened simultaneously, then what, when it will fill? So your A, it is filling 1 upon 36 part in 1 hour. And your B, it will fill 1 upon 45 part in 1 hour. So both will fill, means A plus B, that is 1 upon 36 plus 1 upon 45. If you will add, then you will get 1 upon 20. Or you have another formula, xy upon x plus y. Already we have given you in the previous lecture. Now the second question, a pipe can fill a tank in 15 hours. Due to leak in the bottom, it is filled in 20 hours. If the tank is full, when will empty it? It means that in 1 upon 15 it has been filled and leak in 20 hours, means 1 upon 20. So your overall, if you will calculate, then you will get 1 upon 60. So it will be, the leak will empty full tank in 60 hours. So the tank, it will be empty in 60 hours. That is the 1 upon 60 part in 1 hour. So the tank, it will empty in 60 hours. Now the second question, pipe A can fill a tank in 20 hours. Fill means 1 upon 20. It is filling 1 upon 20 part in 1 hour. While pipe B alone can fill it in 30 hours. And this is A, this is B. It can fill also in 30 hours. It means that it will fill 1 upon 30 part in 1 hour. And C कैन एम्प्टी द फुल टैंक इन 40 आवर्स एंड सी इट विल एम्प्टी इन 40 आवर्स मीन्स इट विल एम्प्टी द टैंक इन 1 आवर दैट इज 1/40 पार्ट सो माइनस मीन्स इट इज इट विल लीक द टैंक एंड पॉजिटिव मीन्स इट विल फिल द टैंक ओके सो इन दिस कंडीशन इफ ऑल द पाइप्स आर ओपनड इट इम्प्लाइज दैट यू हैव टू एड ऑल द डेटा प्लस 1/30 माइनस 1/40 वॉट एवर यू आर गेटिंग द कैलकुलेशन दैट विल बी योर आंसर सो इफ यू कैलकुलेट इट देन यू विल गेट 3/300 ओके सॉरी इट विल बी 7/120 सो दैट विल बी 17/1/7 hours to fill the tank. Okay. Now the question number 4. In what time would a cistern be filled by 3 pipes whose diameters are 1 centimeter, 1/3 centimeter and 2 centimeter running together? Okay. You have this time by 3 pipes, one is 1 centimeter, second is 1/3 and third is 2 centimeter. So you have 3 pipe, that is 1 centimeter, that is 1/3 centimeter and that is 2 centimeter running together. Okay. When the largest alone will fill it in 61 minutes, the amount of water flowing in by each pipe being proportional to the square of its diameter. You have to understand, this is a very good question. So how to solve it? So to solve this question, I will use one paper because this is a long question. Now in 1 minute, the pipe of 2 centimeter diameter fills 1/61 of the cistern. What they have written? 2 centimeter running together when the largest alone will fill it in 61 minute. Largest means 2 centimeter. That is the largest one. So it is taking 2 centimeter. Its diameter is 2 centimeter. So, but it is, it will fill in 61 minute. So in 1 minute, the pipe of 2 centimeter diameter fill 1/61 of the cistern. Now, in 1 minute, the pipe of 1 centimeter, the pipe of 1 centimeter diameter fills 1/61 into 1/4 of the cistern. How? Because the amount of water flowing in by each pipe being proportional to the square of its diameter. Proportional to the square of its diameter. So its diameter, it is 1 centimeter. Square of its diameter. So that is also same. Okay. So 1 centimeter, 1/3 centimeter and 2 centimeter. The amount of water flowing in each of the pipe being proportional to the square of its diameter. So 1 centimeter, that is also diameter. So what we have written here? In 1 minute, the pipe of 1 centimeter diameter fills 1/61 into 1/4 of the cistern. Now similarly, in 1 minute, the pipe of 1 by 3 centimeter diameter fills 1/61 into 4/9 of the cistern. Because your diameter is 1/1/3. 3 into 3 plus 1 is equal to 4. 4/3. So it's a square. That is 4/9 of the cistern. You have to understand the logic. How to calculate this? If you have any question, any query, again we will solve. We are given the amount of water flowing in the proportional to the square of the diameter, that is 2 centimeter diameter, fills 1/61, okay, 61 minute. So 1 centimeter diameter fills 1/61 into 1/2 square. So that will be 1/61 into 1/4. So we have written this. What we have written? The amount of water flowing in by each pipe being proportional to the square of its diameter. Okay. So we have done this. Now, again we will solve. 1/1/3, that is 4/3 centimeter diameter fills 1/61 into 1/4 into 4/3 square. I think that you understand. So if you will calculate, then you will get 1/61 into 4/9 of the cistern. You have to understand the logic, what they have written, the amount of water flowing in by each pipe being proportional to the square of its diameter. So we have done this. Okay. So that is the case. Now you have to add the case number 1, case number 2 and case number 3. So at last, in 1 minute, 1/61, this part, plus 1/61 into 4, this part, plus 4/61 into 9, this part. If you will add everything, then you will get 1/36. This 1/36 of the cistern is filled. Okay, it will fill. So that is your answer. So the overall, the hole is filled in 36 minutes. That is the part. So it will be filled in 36 minutes. Very simple. Now question number 5. There is a leak in the bottom of a cistern. Suppose you have one tank and there is a leak, suppose. Okay, the water is flowing from here. There is a leak of the bottom of the cistern. When the cistern is thoroughly repaired, it would be filled in 3/1/2 hours. Okay. It now takes half an hour longer. Now it is taking half an hour extra of time. If the cistern is full, how long would leak take to empty the cistern? This is a very simple question. Already I have given you. If you have two pipes and both are opened, if you have two pipes and both are opened, so when it will fill? xy/x+y. If you have two pipes, one is opened and one is, suppose you do not have this pipe, one is opened and one is, it will empty. So in this condition, x/x-y. You have to remember this logic. If you have two pipes, both will fill the tank. So in this condition, xy/x+y. If you have two pipe, okay, and one it will fill and second it will empty. In this condition you have to use this formula xy upon x minus y. So here the condition is same. So your value, this is 3.5 and the next one is 4. 3 of 1 by 2 hours, 3.5. Okay, and what about 4? What is 4? There is a leak of the bottom in a cistern. When the cistern is fully repaired, it would be filled in these hours. It now takes half an hour longer, means 3 of 1 by 2 plus half, that is 4. Okay, so 4 minus 3.5, if you will calculate, then your answer, it will be 28 hours. So it is taking total 28 hours. Now the second question, that is also interesting question. If two pipes function simultaneously, the reservoir is filled in 12 hours. One pipe fills the reservoir 10 hours faster than the other. How many hours does the faster pipe take to fill the reservoir? So this is also very simple. Let the faster pipe fills the tank in X hours, then the slower pipe fills the tank in X plus 10 hours. Okay, so when both opened, in this condition again we will use same formula xy upon x plus y, because both opened it is taking x hours and slower it is taking x plus 10. What we have written here, one pipe fills the reservoir 10 hours faster than the others. If it is taking x hours, then it is taking x plus 10. Now we have to use this formula because both opened, so xy upon x plus y, it means that x into x plus 10 upon x plus 10. So what they have given, when both opened, then it is taking 12 hours. The reservoir filled in 12 hours. So this is 12. Now you have to solve this equation. When you will solve this equation, then your answer, that will be x is equal to, you will get 20 and minus 6. Okay. But minus 6, that is nonsense. So your answer is 20. Okay. So that is your high school to solve this problem. Okay. Now the next question. You have three pipes A, B, C can fill a cistern in 6 hours. So your A, B, C that will fill 1 upon 6 part in 1 hour. It means that. Okay. Three pipes A, B, C can fill cistern in 6 hours after working together for 2 hours. Now this is for 1 hour. So in 2 hours, A plus B plus C, it will 2 upon 6 part in 2 hours. Okay, 2 hours. Now C closed. Now C is closed and A and B fill the cistern in 8 hours. Now C has closed. Then find the time in which the cistern can be filled by pipe C. Very simple question. So A plus B plus C, that is 1 upon 6 part, and A plus B plus C, it will fill 1 upon 3 part in 2 hours. So the remaining part, so that is 1 upon 3. Now remaining part is equal to 1 minus 1 upon 3. 1 minus 1 upon 3, that is 2 upon 3. सो दिस पार्ट ए एंड बी इट हैज बीन फिल्ड इन 8 आवर्स. सो ए प्लस बी कैन फिल इट इन 8 × 3/2. ओके सो दैट इज द पार्ट. सो इट विल फिल इन अपोजिट ऑफ दिस इंटू 8. ओके सो दैट विल बी 8 आवर्स. ओके इफ यू विल कैलकुलेट 2 × 4 = 8, 4 × 3 = 12, सॉरी 12 आवर्स. सो एंड वी हैव ए प्लस बी प्लस सी, इट कैन फिल इन 6 आवर्स. सो नाउ सी इज इक्वल टू ए प्लस बी प्लस सी माइनस ए प्लस बी कैन फिल इन 1 आवर इज इक्वल टू ए प्लस बी प्लस सी 1/6 एंड ए प्लस बी 1/12. ओके इफ यू कैलकुलेट 12 − 6/12 × 6 देन योर आंसर 12 आवर्स. वेरी सिंपल क्वेश्चन. ओके आई थिंक दैट यू अंडरस्टैंड. नाउ नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. सो नाउ द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, इफ 3 टैप्स आर ओपन्ड टूगेदर, ए टैंक इज फिल्ड इन 12 आवर्स, वन ऑफ द टैप्स कैन फिल इट इन 10 आवर्स एंड अनादर इन 15 आवर्स, हाउ डज द थर्ड टैप वर्क? इफ 3 टैप्स आर ओपन टूगेदर, ए टैंक फिल्ड इन 12 आवर्स, ओके वन ऑफ टैप कैन फिल इन 10 आवर्स एंड अनादर इन 15 आवर्स, हाउ डज द थर्ड टैप विल वर्क? वेरी सिंपल. यू नो दैट हियर यू हैव वन टैंक एंड यू हैव 3 टैप. ओके एंड यू हैव ओपन एवरी वन, 3 टैप्स आर ओपन टूगेदर, ए टैंक इज फिल्ड इन 12 आवर्स. मीन्स इफ यू विल ओपन दिस प्लस दिस प्लस दिस देन इट विल बी इन 12 आवर्स. सो 1/12 पार्ट इट विल बी कंप्लीटेड इन 1 आवर्स. इट मीन्स दैट वन ऑफ द टैप कैन फिल इन 10 आवर्स, सो 1/10 पार्ट. And second one is 1/15. What about third? Very simple. You have to calculate it. It will take only 2 or 3 seconds. Okay. To solve such type of problem. So, I think that you understand. So, how to solve another question. So now what is the answer of this question? So 1/z it will be 1/12 minus 1/10 minus 1/15. Okay, now you can calculate. Very simple. So it will be, if you solve it, then or another method, I can also give you another method. Suppose we have to fill the nature of the third tab. Now here also we have to think also about the nature of the, if you will calculate it, what is the LCM of 12, 10 and 15? 12, 10 and 15, what is the LCM? So 5, 12, 5 × 10, 5 × 3 = 15, okay, 3, 3 × 4 = 12, 2, 3 × 1 = 3, and this is 2, 2 × 4 = 2, then this is 2. So 5 × 3 = 15, 15 × 2 = 30, 30 × 2 = 60. So 60, okay, 12 × 5 = 60, and 10 × 6 = 60, and 15 × 2 = 60. So 6, 7, so this is 5 − 7/60. So 5 − 7 = −2/60, so this is −1/30 something. So that is something different. So again we will solve this question by another method. So that is something different. because we don't know the nature of the tap, so it is something different. Okay, so let and we have also known if three tap it has been opened, one tap, two tap, three tap, it has been opened and all are opened and they will fill the tank. So in this condition your trick already we have given, you must go in the previous lecture, xyz upon xy plus yz plus zx. If it is taking x hours, it is taking y hours, it is taking z hours, so when it will filled, so that is the trick, xyz upon xy plus yz plus zx. So now the first one is 10, okay, the second one is 15, let the third one is z upon xy 10 into 15 plus yz means 15 into z, 15z plus zx means this 10z. If you'll calculate it, so but the overall they are taking 12 hours, okay, so that will be 12 in this condition. Now both are same, only something is different, I will just show you. So ten into 15 into z is equal to 12 into 10 into 15 plus 15 z plus 10 z. Now you have to solve. If you will solve, then your z it will be minus 12. You can check. So if the value of z is negative, it means that the nature of the third tap means that is not here, that is here, means it will leak the tank. This is not the nature of the tap. Okay, if you are getting negative, so the nature of the tap is negative. Here we have done something the wrong calculation, so that is wrong, but that is the best method. Also now the second question, if A, B, C are three pipes, so I will explain you. Here we have done this wrong. What? 15 forza. Because of the light we have done here something wrong, okay. Sometimes the lights it's come, sometimes the light go. So that is 5 minus 10. So 5 minus 10. So 5 minus 10 is equal to minus 5. So that is minus 12. So both calculations are same. If you will also solve this problem, this already we have done this one. So LCM of this is 10 into 15 into Z. And if we will divide this to this one, then you will get 15 into Z. If you will divide 15 to this, then you will get 10 into Z. If you'll divide z to this one, then you will get 10 into 15. So after the calculation, you will get again 1 upon 12. So minus means the tap, it will empty the tank. Otherwise, it will fill. Okay, that is the answer. So now the question number second. A, B, C are three pipes connected to a tank. You have one tank and there are three pipes. Here I don't know about the nature of the tap. Three pipe connected to a tank and A and B together fill the tank in 6 hours. Okay. B and C together fill in 10 hours. Means A plus B it can fill 1 upon 6 part in 1 hour. And B and C can fill 1 upon 10 part in 1 hour. ठीक है, A and C together fill the tank in, A plus C can fill in 7 means 1 upon 7 to the 14 or 15, 15 upon 2 means 2 upon 15 part in 1 hour. ओके, इन हाउ मच टाइम विल एबीसी सेपरेटली, वेरी सिंपल, वेरी सिंपल, यू विल एड एवरी वन, टू ऑफ ए प्लस बी प्लस सी इज इक्वल टू, इफ यू एड इक्वेशन नंबर 1, 2, 3 देन यू विल गेट दिस, ए इट हैज कम टू टाइम्स, बी इट हैज कम टू टाइम्स, सी इट हैज कम टू टाइम्स, सो दैट विल बी 1/6 प्लस 1/10 प्लस 2/15, 7 × 14 = 15, ओके, सो नाउ यू हैव टू सॉल्व इट, सो सो वट इज द कैलकुलेशन, सो योर कैलकुलेशन ए प्लस बी प्लस सी इज इक्वल टू विद इन दिस इज 5/2, दैट इफ यू कैलकुलेट दिस इज 5/2 देन दिस इज 5 देन आफ्टर देन यू विल गेट 5 hours, सो इट विल फिल द टैंक ए बी सी इन 5 hours, यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट इट, दिस इज वेरी सिंपल, ओके, सो 6, 10, 15, 6, 10, 15, इफ यू हैव एनी प्रॉब्लम देन वी कैन कैलकुलेट 6 × 10 × 15, ओके, देन दिस इज इफ यू हैव टू डिवाइड दिस वन देन यू विल गेट 10 × 15, ओके, प्लस इफ यू विल डिवाइड 10 टू दिस देन यू विल गेट 6 × 15, प्लस इफ यू विल डिवाइड दिस देन यू विल गेट 6 × 10, ओके, दिस कैलकुलेशन इज इक्वल टू 2a + b + c, ओके, नाउ दिस इज 150 प्लस, और यू कैन कैलकुलेट, ओके, एंड और यू कैन कैलकुलेट लाइक दिस ऑल्सो, 3 × 2 = 6, 3 × 5 = 15, 3 × 2 = 6, 3 × 2 = 6, नंबर वन, ओके, 2 × 1 = 2, 2 × 1 = 2, 2 × 5 = 10, 2 × 5 = 10, एंड यू कैन सी 5 ऑल्सो हियर, 5 × 3 = 15, 5 × 1 = 5, 5 × 3 = 15, 5 × 2 = 10, ओके, ओके, नाउ यू कैन नॉट सॉल्व, सो हियर 5, यू हैव ओनली 5 हियर, एंड हियर यू हैव ओनली 3, दैट इज अ शॉर्टकट मेथड, हियर यू हैव ओनली 2, एंड हियर यू हैव 5 × 10, 10 × 3 = 30, तो 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10/30, दैट इज 1/3 समथिंग, सो कैलकुलेशन द कैलकुलेशन, आई थिंक दैट अगेन वी हैव डन समथिंग रॉन्ग, ओके, वी आवर कैलकुलेशन इज रॉन्ग बिकॉज वी फॉरगेट दिस डेटा टू राइट हियर, ओके, वी फॉरगेट दिस डेटा टू राइट हियर, 2 इज ऑल्सो हियर, इफ यू डिवाइड दिस वन देन यू विल गेट 10 × 15, इफ यू डिवाइड दिस वन देन यू विल गेट 6 × 15, ओके, इफ यू डिवाइड दिस देन यू विल गेट 6 × 10, 6 × 10, बट 2 इज ऑल्सो हियर, वी फॉरगेट द 2, यू हैव टू रिमेंबर, ओके, यू हैव टू राइट ऑल द डेटा, सो After calculation, your 2 is also here. So 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So that is 12/30. So your answer that will be 2/5. Okay, 2/5. So 2abc is equal to, you are getting, that is a plus b plus c is equal to 5 hours. Because it was 2/5. So 2 and 2 cancel, then a plus b plus c is equal to 5 hours. Now if you have calculated a plus b plus c, already you know a plus b can do together within 6 hours. So a plus b plus c will complete 1/5 part in 1 hour. And a plus b can fill in 1/6 part, so that is a plus b 1/6 part plus c is equal to 1/5, so c is equal to 1/5 minus 1/6, so again 6 minus 5 is equal to 1, 5 × 6 = 30, means c will complete 1/30 part in 1 hour, it means that c will fill in 30 hours. Similarly you can find for a and b, because they have given us a and c and b and c. Very simple question. If you want to find A ए प्लस बी प्लस सी, ऑलरेडी दे हैव गिवन अस 1/5 पार्ट, वी हैव डन. नाउ बी प्लस सी, बी प्लस सी दे कैन फिल इन 10 आवर्स, मीन्स दे विल फिल 1/10 पार्ट, ओके, इज इक्वल टू 1/5. सो ए इज इक्वल टू 1/5 माइनस 1/10, आंसर. नाउ ए प्लस बी प्लस सी इज इक्वल टू 1/5 पार्ट. Now A and C they have given us, that is 7 to 14, 15. 15/2 means 2/15. 2/15 part plus B is equal to 1/5. So B is equal to 1/5 minus 2/15. So that is your answer. If you will solve, then you will get the A, that is 10 hours. Okay. And B, C, 30 hours we have done, and B is equal to 15 hours. Okay. So I think that you understand all the problems. Now next question, two pipes can separately fill a tank in 20 hours and 30 hours. Okay, two pipes separately 20 hours and 30 hours. You have two pipe. It is filling the tank in 20 hours, means 1/20 part in 1 hour. And 1/30 part in 1 hour. So this is A pipe and this is B pipe. Both pipe are opened to fill the tank, but when the tank is 1/3 full, a leak after then a leak develop. Okay. A leak develop in the tank through which 1/3 of the water supplied by both the pipes leak out. Okay, what is the total time taken to fill the tank? Very simple. So both are filling, but it will empty. In this condition, at first you have to find how much part they have filled in 1 hour. So that is xy upon x plus y. Very simple. So means you have to add this 1/20 plus 1/30. So 20 into 30 upon 20 plus 30 means is equal to 12 hours. Both can fill in 12 hours, and both can fill in 1 hours 1/12 part of the tank. So 1/3 part they have filled of tank is filled in 12/3 is equal to 4 hours. So they both have filled 1/3 part of the tank in 4 hours. Now 1/3 of supplied water leak out. Okay. In this condition, you have 1 minus 1/3 is equal to 2/3 part. This part is efficient as earlier. Now the work of 12 minus 4, it can fill in 12 hours. Work is equal to, and this 1/3 tank is filled in 4 hours. So the work of 12 minus 4 is equal to 8 hours will be completed now in 8 divide 2/3 this part. So it will be 8 into 3/2 is equal to 12 hours. So it will take 12 hours. Total time is equal to 12 hours to fill this 2/3 part. And already the both of A and B, it has been done in 4 hours. Means 1/3 part it has done in 4 hours, and the remaining 2/3 parts that it has been done in 12 hours. So 12 plus 4. Your 12 plus 4, that is 16. So it will take total 16 hours to fill it. Now at last, this is a very common question. A cistern is normally filled in 8 hours, okay, but takes 2 hours longer to fill because of leak in its bottom. If the cistern is full, a very simple question. You have one tank, so if you have one pipe, it can fill the pipe number A, it can fill 1/8 part in 1 hour. Now there is a leak. Suppose if there is a leak in this condition, it will take 2 hours longer, means extra 2 hours. Suppose the leak can empty in x hours. It means that 1/8 minus 1/x is equal to x minus 8/8x part filled in 1 hour. Okay. So cistern, your tank will be filled in 8x/x-8, and that is 8x/x-8. This total time is 8, it is taking, and extra 2 hours it is taking. This total time, if you open both of the pipe, this pipe number A and leakage pipe, then it will take total time 2 hours extra, means 8 plus 2. So if you calculate, then your x, it will be 40 hours. So it will take 40 hours, means your leak, it can empty the tank in 40 hours. This leak tap can empty the tank in 40 hours and it will empty 1/40 part in 1 hour. I think that you understand all the problems. Okay. Thank you so much.